One of the biggest issues that I think we have as a society is that on a day-to-day basis, we are inundated with the thoughts and feelings of, and emotions of everyone on the planet. And I think one of the problems with that is that we don't often give ourselves enough time to sit with our own thoughts and our own ideas and our own emotions. And that's why I'm actually really glad that the developer of the topic that we're going to cover today, which is Journiv, reached out to me when he did. Just for a little bit of a backstory on me, and I'll try to keep this short. Over the past few weeks, I've been dealing with a lot of anxiety that I can't place. I don't know why it's there. I don't know what's going on. I'm working on it with medical professionals to try to get better. But one of the things that, therapists and again, medical professionals will tell you to do is write things down. And it's easy to say that, but very often it's hard to get started to know, you know, what to put on the paper, the page, the however you want to get your thoughts and feelings out. And there's actually one of the features that I want to talk about a little bit about Journiv that I think will help people at least start to engage with themselves a bit more often to put more thought into their thinking process. So that's what I want to cover today is Journiv. There's a couple of different ways that we can deploy Journiv. I think it's Journiv. Anyway, it could be Journiv, but I'm going to call it Journiv. There's a couple of different ways that you can deploy it. We're going to take the simple approach to this as we go through this installation process when we get there. But first, what we're going to do is take a look at the instance that I have, and then we'll talk about the different installation methods. That said, when I say different installation methods, there's a simple Docker version and a more complex Docker version. So typical disclaimers here. I'm not the developer of this app. I tried to make that apparent a moment ago, but I am not the developer of this app. They just reached out to see if I'd be interested in taking a look at it. They're not paying me. They're not going to see this before you do. They just wanted me to take a look and possibly share it with you guys. So that's what we're doing. Again, the second part of this is that this is in Docker. So if Docker's not your thing, there are lots of other journaling apps out there that do something similar to this. But we're going to take a look at this app because it's in Docker and that's what we do here. If you want to get help or support or whatever with features or bugs with the app, definitely reach out to the developers via their official channels. Again, I'm not going to be able to help you as much as they will with regards to getting this deployed. So I think with that said, let's take a quick look at the very basic instance that I have up and running, and then we'll take a look at a couple of different ways that you can install this. So this is my installation of Journiv. I've had it installed for about 5 days and have only written in it twice, so there's not much in here. But let's just kind of take a look through the interface and we'll talk about some things as we go here. Top left, we've got our name. That's what you would expect to see, where you would expect to see it. But you'll also notice that there is a beta tag here. So this is still a work in progress, and that's very important as we kind of go through some different things. So today, this is today, right? And basically, this is what the screen that we're looking at here in the middle. And it says Journiv. We've got a little fire icon there that says one because I've only written in it twice over 5 days. This is your writing streak. Below that, we've got today's prompt. I wrote in it this morning prior to starting this video. So there isn't a prompt here, but anytime you log in for the first time on a given day after midnight, I think local time, it will have a new writing prompt for you and you can start writing based on that. Now, that said, you don't have to base your journaling on the writing prompt. It's just to kind of help get your creativity going, your thought process going about what you might want to write about today and get you thinking about something to let you just kind of free flow. And it's just, I love the idea of having a prompt here to engage your brain and ask what about. So, that is today's prompt. Again, I've already filled that in. That was right down here. And then we've got on this day. So start writing to create memories that will appear here in future years. So they're very much planning based on what I'm seeing here of keeping the development and the maintaining of this app going for a long time. And I genuinely hope they do. So because I've only written in it twice over 5 days, no memories here yet. Below that, we've got a couple of entries. Again, the prompts were what childhood activity sparked your imagination. I saw that and I wrote about it, right? And I wrote about it a bit. And then down here at the end, it lets you put in your feeling, your emotion while you were writing this or for your day or whatever there, right? And we'll take a look at actually writing something here in a little bit. The first day that I had this installed, the prompt was, what does friendship mean to you today? And of course, that was just a picture. I wanted to see what would happen if I put a picture in there. That's Cloud from like 12 years ago. So, you know, I wrote about it. It wasn't much, but it kind of got me thinking about how this app might actually help me get my thoughts out or make me actually think about my thoughts versus just keeping them bottled up. So down here, my feeling, my emotion in this moment was curious. So if we come back to today, there's nothing really to scroll there. So that's kind of, it is what it is. Down here in the very bottom right-hand corner, kind of by my head, like right over here, you can click write and you can choose from which journal, or you can choose which journal you'd like to place this. You can change the date of it for whatever reason. I'm sure there's a reason for this. The people who journal frequently might have a better understanding of, but you can change the date. You can add a title, you can just start writing about your day, your feelings, your reflections, whatever the case is. Again, you can add images, you can add tags, and you can add your mood here all at the bottom. And then once you're done writing that, you can click save, and then it will show up here on your homepage. So that's kind of the basic gist of it. If we come over here to journals, again, we've got a couple of them here. The Getting Started, this is my first journal, as it says there, was the one I created when I set this up. And then because I was curious about how other journals might show up, I wanted to see that. So I created an example second journal. And again, like we saw here a moment ago, when you go in here to write, in fact, I probably, this is just gonna let me add new journals from here. That's what that one is. So we come back to here and click write. Again, we can choose which journal we'd like to write in. So I think that's great. So again, we've got our journals, we've got our insights here, current streak, longest streak, total entries, total words, average words per entry, all of that is here. And we can see kind of a chart as far as our journaling is concerned. And here we can see I wrote on Wednesday and it is now Monday. So those are the days that I wrote. And if I had more journal entries in each of these, that chart would be different. So again, you know, this month's productivity, journaling performance, all of that is down here if you want to take a look. We've got mood trends, so you can see total mood logs. And most frequent was anxious. I think that's a bit of a misnomer since I've only entered it once. I don't know that that's necessarily the most frequent, but it is the most recent. Here we can see a mood trend over the last 7 days. So this is where I think this might be beneficial for someone like me who kind of wants to keep tabs on things. So here we can see this was curious, right? This is, I entered curious on this Wednesday. That's rated a 3. Anxious is apparently rated a 2. And we can see that little dip there. And then we can see mood distribution, mood streak, recent moods. All of those are in there as well. Again, we can click new entry, just like going over here, over to today and clicking the button. We can just click new entry, and I love that as well. Settings, we can click over here. Of course, my account, the appearance, system theme. There is a system light and dark, and that is it. This is currently dark mode. But I guess we can look at light mode. It is very bright. So I'm going to switch it back to system, but just know you do have options there. Server configuration, you can change this as necessary and you can test the connection and save the configuration. Then we get into our account, we can edit our profile, we can change our password. Not much we can do there really other than change our name and our time zone. And then again, we can update our password, we can export our data, our journal entries, or delete our account. And then there is support for help and feedback and about as far as the app version and information. I think the one thing that I would really like to see with this that I just noticed after I added the second journal is in the settings, have a default journal, right? Like, because when you go in and add an entry, the most recent journal that you've added will be at the top. top, right? So these are order of newest to oldest. I would like to have a default journal set so I don't accidentally forget to switch to the one that I'm going to primarily write in. So I would like to have a default journal setting in there somewhere. But other than that, I really, really dig what they've done with this app. Now, the one question that I did forget to ask when I was chatting with the developer over email is, where are the prompts coming from? Is there a database of prompts somewhere? I don't know that part. I'm genuinely curious about that myself. So maybe the developer of the app will see this and leave a comment down below to let me know where the journaling prompts are stored or where they're coming from, that sort of thing. I'd love to know that. But I think with that said, I want to jump over to the GitHub repository and take a look at the installation process. Because as I mentioned, there are a couple of different ways that we can go about this. So let's jump over to my desktop. And there is a GitHub repository here that we can see. Some of this was updated just a few days ago, and I love this. There's also a website. I've got that popped open over here. And you can take a look. All of this will be linked in the video description. And you can kind of see, you know, more information about it. So if we come back to here, of course, you can dig through the code as much as you'd like. I know somebody the other day said that I should mention what these apps are written in. I'm not sure why it matters, but it looks like JavaScript, Python, and other. So there's that. Also, we've got 284 stars on this. So if you like the project, definitely go give it a star. So we can dig through. Again, we've got three different Docker Compose files. One is for development, and it's not really all that different from the production one, but there's a lot going on in there. There is the Docker Compose.prod.yaml, and I'm gonna close this so it doesn't do it to me later. And going through this, there's quite a bit going on with this, right? So there are two versions of the app in the big Docker Compose. There's a Journiv SQLite app, which is effectively what I'm using. And then from there, you can, I guess, switch it to a Postgres database if you wanted to go that route, because there's a lot of other stuff in the environment variables for this. So just something to keep in mind. There's a lot in here, and I ran into several issues trying to deploy it this way. After that, we get into the Postgres database itself. And then down here, there is the Postgres version of the app that has basically all of the same environment variables here. And again, going this route, I ran into several issues. Part of it was the way some of it's configured, I believe. The other part of it is running into things I'd never actually seen before in a Docker Compose file. So for instance, profiles, I'd never actually seen this before. It's kind of a cool idea. Like they've done here, there's two different versions of the app that you can deploy from this Docker Compose, depending on the profile flag that you throw at it during the deployment process via command line. I had never actually seen that before. I think it's kind of cool, but I think it's kind of confusing if you're not paying attention and you don't know that it's there. That was my fault for not paying attention. But again, I hadn't seen it before, so I didn't think to look for it. If we scroll up, we can see that the first version of the app, this one right here at the very top, which is by default the SQLite version of the app, It is actually part of both the default and the SQLite profile. So if you deploy just using Docker Compose up -d, you will get the SQLite version by default. However, if you throw the Postgres profile flag at it, you'll get this other version of the app. Kind of a cool bit of technology built into Docker that I was unaware of. I feel kind of silly. I've been at this for a long time and I didn't know that was a thing. But there were just some issues that I ran into besides my own ignorance with regards to the app. The way this is written, when I change the app port in the env file that we'll take a look at in a second, it changed both sides of this to that app port versus it just being the first half before the colon. So configuration mishap happened there. It's not a big deal. It's just something I encountered. Again, this is in beta, so there's going to be little hiccups here and there. I want to be clear about that. So again, if we come over to here, this is the Docker Compose that I'm using. It's that SQLite version. It's on port 8000 by default. If you're using Portainer, 8000 is already taken. So change this version of 8000. Don't change the colon or anything after it. Generate a secret key or mash your keyboard a bunch and replace this with something secure. Make sure that this has your IP address or your domain that you're going to use for this. Volume here, we initially did some testing back and forth using a mapped volume versus a Docker volume. And the Docker volume, it did it again. The Docker volume was the more successful version of that. So you can try a mapped volume, but the permissions may be a bit wonky. The developer and I found this to be the better way to go about it. So Docker volume for the win in this case. You can deploy this via Portainer, Dockage, command line, however you want to deploy it. And then once you've done that, you'll be asked to create an account, and then you can start journaling just very, very quickly. So that's Journiv, really. And I'm really, really happy that there's something like this out there. And I'm sure that there are other versions of this out there as well. But I'm really glad that this kind of showed up on my radar when it did. And I think if I can get myself in the habit of using it regularly, it may help me kind of clear out my brain from some clutter. I would love to know from you guys what your thoughts are on journaling. Are you doing it? Have you considered doing it? Would an app like Journiv help encourage you to do that more regularly? Again, to take control of your thoughts or get your thoughts out so they don't bubble up and fester and make you want to explode. Would love to know all of that in the comment section down below. Links to everything will be in the video description. I recently launched some merch after hitting 100,000 subscribers. So there should be merch links like directly under this video, but there will also be a store link in the video description as well, if you want to jump over there and take a look at some hoodies or t-shirts or stickers or whatever. So I think with that said, I'm going to wrap this up. I do want to thank you guys for spending a few minutes of your day with me here today, and I'll talk to you in the next video.